I'm Campbell McCubbin, collector of magic boxes. I've been collecting cameras for, 45 or more years. I've always been a junk store aficionado, a garage sale haunter. And one day I realized how much photography has meant to me. And I think, as I said earlier, the magic box is what makes it so fascinating for me. Where else can you find a little box made out of wood, tin, plastic, that you can point somewhere and save a piece of history, a piece of time if you want. It doesn't have to be historical. That's what fascinates me about photography. And it comes in so many shapes and forms, and they're all relatively small, this piece notwithstanding, and can fit in a small room like this room here. They're not allowed out of this room, by the way. I am married, so they have their place. Going to garage sales and thrift shops all over the world have actually filled this room to the point where when one camera comes in, the other has to leave. As I say, I am married. I'm a garage saler from way back and a thrift shopper from way back, and I had been a photographer, an amateur photographer for a number of years. And I made friends with a fellow who worked at a photography shop. And I was at his house for dinner one night, and he said, "I'll show you my pride and joy." I thought he was going to bring a beautiful Nikon system out or something like that, but instead he brought this old Kodak folder, a 3A Kodak folder out. He said, "Look at this. I had this restored, and it's fabulous, and it's worth thousands." And I said, "Well, I see those all the time. I see them for $2, $3, and $4, and $5. And he said, "Buy them." And, you know, that's when it started. I started buying old folders, and I went from the old folders to twin lens reflexes to single lens reflexes to spy cameras to, well, little miniature toy cameras, and then from there it really got crazy. I discovered eBay and started buying, because people were giving me them all the time, little figurines of people with cameras. So the figurines and the people with cameras and the porcelain statuettes of people with cameras have sort of become the focus of my collection, pardon the pun not intended, and the cameras have become the backdrop. Well, photography is, 170 years old by now, 2009, that's 170 years old, but we're not going to take you year by year through 170 years. I think we can sort of eliminate the first century by saying that they were experimental scientists. These were people who were mixing chemicals, doing all sorts of wacky stuff with it. But by the time the end of the 19th century arrived, around 1890 or so, this is not a camera. This is actually a flask. Sorry about that. But getting back to the cameras, this simple little magic box is what revolutionized photography and took it out of the hands of the scientists, the experimenters, and more into the hands of the hobbyist and the person who just wanted to take a picture. This one is from about 1898. It's the Kodak No. 2 Bullseye version of 1898. Look at that lovely box. I love the smell of these things. Cedar box in a lovely, lovely wooden case and covered in leather. This one is one of the ones that Kodak said, "You push the button and we do the rest." Well, you might have seen one of these in a thrift shop or an antique store, or if you're lucky, in your grandma's attic. But this is a stereoscope. And it's the sort of early equivalent of the ViewMaster. You probably remember the ViewMaster. We had Roy Rogers. This is what they were doing in about 1892, or maybe a little later than that, certainly the turn of the century, in the evenings before television. They were looking at stereo pictures, three-dimensional pictures. If you've never tried one, you gotta have a look. You maybe wondered, you may have seen one of these, but you probably haven't seen one of these. This is the type of camera that took those three-dimensional pictures. Two lenses to approximate the distance between your eyes to give you the three-dimensional effect when you look through the picture, through the viewer at the picture. This is a beautiful old Blair Hawkeye. It's one of my prides and joys. Sometime around the 30s and 40s, the press really got into photography. It was the ideal replacement for drawn pictures in newspapers. And this is the one that changed that business forever. It's called the Crown Graphic, the Speed Graphic, another variation of it. This is the one you see in the movies. Okay, boys, let's get a picture. Miss Monroe, please smile. Well, now we're into movie cameras, and this is the way most people, I guess, today think of a movie camera. This is a bit bigger than the modern ones, but this is not the way this one was used at all. This one was a horizontal movie camera, made by Zeiss Icon of Germany. And I'll tell you, this has got the most complex inner workings I've ever seen in an 8mm movie camera. Well, you remember I said Kodak all those years ago said, you push the button and we do the rest. Well, about 1948, a gentleman called Edwin Land decided that you should push the button and there's nothing else to do. And thus, Edwin Land invented the Polaroid Land camera, named after Edwin Land, not anything to do with shooting land. And it made pictures in 1 minute. And when you were finished, you actually pulled the picture out of here. I mean, look at the process involved here. And you slid the picture out, you coated it was still wet, and you cleaned it off, and you waved it around for a while, and then slowly this beautiful black and white image would emerge from the Polaroid Land camera. Revolutionized photography one more time. Instant photography became all the rage until it died because of the advent of digital photography. Okay, smile now. Oh, that's nice. The digital age, as I say, it revolutionized a lot of things. Convergence is the big buzzword now. Not new. Convergence, are you kidding? These guys claim this is all new. Camera in your cell phone. Well, here's my camera from 1944, maybe 45. This is the Tom Thumb camera. Well, it's not just a camera. It is a camera, but it's also a radio. You can tune in your favorite AM station and rock along to the songs while you're shooting your picture. Smile. Bond. James Bond. Well, James Bond might have had the highest technology of his time, but more than 100 years ago, Sherlock Holmes might have had one of these. This is the Expo Pocket Watch camera for official police use only. It says right on the box. This was sold to kids, actually, around the turn of the last century for about $1.50 a piece. Nickel-plated, looks like a pocket watch, but you remove the winder, point, and shoot. Just checking the time, folks, just checking the time. You know, over the years, camera manufacturers have tried to appeal to the feminine side of its of the market, and they've done it in many different ways. This is one of my favorites. This is the Petey Vanity camera from Walter Koenig, 1950-something in Germany. Now, you might think this is a beautiful camera, and indeed it is. It's done in tortoise shell, beautiful, and it looks, for all the world, like a miniature camera. You don't know how miniature this is. This is the camera. So what's the rest of this all about? Well, this is a woman's compact. A little powder your nose, a little mirror, and we've got a roll of film is over here. This is the lipstick, a tube of lipstick, two rolls of film for the miniature camera, and the well-dressed woman of the 50s would be carrying around the Petey Vanity from Walter Koenig. So we've come pretty much full circle over the last century of photography, all the way back to where we began. And this, by the way, is, speaking of centuries, the Century Kodak Studio camera from 1900. Gorgeous piece of equipment, but very large. But do you know what this is? This is the very latest in camera technology. It's a digital camera in a pill, the gastrointestinal camera. When swallowed, and yes, you do swallow it, it will travel the entire length of your gastrointestinal tract taking photographs 2 per second, 50,000 photographs, as it makes the route from here all the way, well, down to there. And when it comes out the other end, it's normally disposed of the way they normally are, but the kind person who gave me this sterilized it within an inch of its life, and I have kept it ever since proudly. It's amazing. And just to show you that I know that it's sterile, I'm going to take it myself. Pill? Oh, I'm going to need something to drink with that, though. Oh, no. I think I got something handy here. Oh, this'll do. A little nice cup of tea. Cheers. Oh, it's gone. Oh my God. What am I going to do now? I'll never get it back. Oh, no.